Hi students, I am Bhakyalakshmi, English teacher of you. Everybody knows me. Now you are promoted to 8th standard without writing few exams. I believe you are safe and happy. Now we have to spend the quarantine period, very valuable one. Let us go for the lesson, poem 1, The Ant and the Cricket. So first I have to give the introduction for this poem. A fable is a short story in which animals behave like humans and convey a message. This poem has a story format between the ant and the cricket. Cricket means like a grasshopper. So you know the one more cricket, but this cricket is grasshopper. The cricket is chilly, that does not care about future and keeps enjoying the summer season rather than collecting food or making a shelter for itself. Whereas the ant is very wise, everybody knows. It gathers food for itself and makes shelter. Now I read out the poem, listen carefully. A silly young cricket accustomed to sing through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come, not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground, not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. So I have segregated this poem into four parts to explain. For this first part, explanation is, in this first part, the cricket is very happy and in jolly mood, sings a song in the spring and summer season rather than collecting food for winter. However, soon the months are past, the cricket is in trouble. There was no food in its cupboard, even there was no small piece of breadcrumbs. This is the first part of the explanation. Now I am going to read the second part of the poem. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me, at last by starvation and famine made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with cold. Away he set off the miserly ant to see if to keep him alive he would grant him shelter from rain and a mouthful grind. He wished only to borrow, he had repaid tomorrow. If not, he must die of starvation and sorrow. This is the second part of the poem. I have to explain this poem, second part. The cricket had not eaten anything and it was starving. That means there was no food for it. It was very hungry. It started to seek the help from tiny ant. It believed that the ant might be helped it. The cricket got shivering a lot while traveling up hungry. It requested the ant to give shelter and food, and it promised to pay everything if the ant is not done so, it will die. This is the second part of the poem's explanation. So now I am going to read the third part of the explanation. Third part of the poem, says the ant to the cricket, I am your servant and friend, but we ants never borrow and we ants never lend. But tell me, dear cricket, did you lie nothing by when the weather was warm, quoth the cricket, not I. Quoth in the sense, said. My heart was so light that I sang day and night, for all nature looked hey. You sang, sir. You sang, sir, you say. This is the third part. So this third part, I give the explanation. Just listen carefully. The ant heard everything and the ant said, I will accept you as a servant or friend, but we have a principle, that is, never borrow anything from other and never lend anything. So the ant asked the cricket, why didn't you gather anything when the weather was warm? Cricket replied that the heart was so light and I was happy and I did not care about the future. So I thought that the beauty of the spring and summer as well as the more food and shelter always remain there. So these things replied by cricket. So now the third part of the poem, Go then, says the ant, and dance the winter away. Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket and out of the door turned the poor little cricket. Folks, call this fable, I will warrant it true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two. This poem's adapted from Aesop's fables. That fables means story, everybody knows. So you have heard this word often. Now this fourth part of the explanation. The ant said hastily, that means hurriedly, lifted the door, that means quickly entered the conversation. Now the conclusion is, the poet says that two legs cricket in the sense the human beings, as well as four-legged cricket, that means who the people do not care about future. So let us see the figure of speech in this poem. So we have the figure of speech in this poem is personification and alliteration. First I have to recall what is personification. Personification means investing human qualities on non-living things. In this poem, a silly young cricket accustomed to sing. This line is personification. Then we have alliteration also in this poem. That is alliteration in the sense, it is repetition of initial consonant sounds in a single line. So everybody knows that, I think so. So here, the second line of this poem, through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring. So the consonant letter start with sunny, summer, spring. So three words are start with S. So these are alliteration. So likewise, we have many alliteration in this poem. You have to check it out. So I think so, you have understood very clearly. So follow the learning. Keep on touching it. Thank you. Bye bye. See you in the next class.